When reviewing your project go through thousands of articles, it's quite likely that there are discrepancies in the votes they submit. That's why it's usually expected that you report how much those discrepancies were and what you did to handle that. Let's see how you can use HubMeta to help you in reporting those. Here I'm going to use the example of an existing project of mine where I had two reviewers and one of them went through all my PDFs, the other looked at about 1200 of them. So this discrepancy rate, of course, is calculated for the ones that both of them looked at. What this number tells me is that in 18% of the cases, or in 226 of them, the reviewers did not agree. So they submitted different votes. And so I have to report this number. But in addition, what is usually expected is that you report a number which is called Cohen's Kappa. So to calculate that, you click on this and HubMeta calculates that for you. In this case, my Cohen's Kappa is 0.5, and this is a table to help you make interpretation of the Kappa ratio. And in this case, it shows that I have moderate agreement between my voters. So you might ask, what happens in cases where you have more than two reviewers for the same article? In those cases, we usually use a measure called Fleiss's Kappa. And I will share a link to this article on real statistics. It explains what is Cohen's Kappa as a measure of agreement between two raters and explains the extension is called Fleiss's Kappa and gives you all the formulation. And these are the formulas that we have used to calculate Fleiss's Kappa in HubMeta. The next question you might have is, how do you actually handle these discrepancies? I would say that's not terribly difficult. You would just select based on these filters. So show me all the ones where one of them said yes and the other said no. And this is basically a case of discrepancy. And the best thing you can do is to simply look at all these articles yourself and make decisions. Sometimes in this process, you find that one of the reviewers had a misconception about something. So it's good to ask them, is it true that you made this assumption when you were submitting a no vote? Or why did you make a judgment to reject or accept this article where in fact it should have been the reverse? And usually through those conversations and debates, you will find where the issue is and you can find a fix for it.